All right, welcome back to the AX live stream, ladies and gentlemen. This is Andrew J. Landy and, of course, Alpha Takahashi with us. Alpha, how are we doing today so far?
It is wonderful! We have more people than like we have ever had. And you know what? It's a weekend, so of course, everyone is here. And you haven't come yet, we still have tomorrow.
Indeed. So, again, folks, make sure you're sharing out the live stream. And let us know that you're watching by tweeting out with the hashtag AX live stream. Mm-hmm. Now, we do have a couple of special guests here today. If you guys are really interested in how it works with composing video game music, our next guests here are masters of it, and they've been in the industry for quite a long time. They have quite a bit of know-how on what goes on with composing. Can you tell us a little bit about yourselves, who you are, and how you're involved? Go ahead. Yeah.
Absolutely. I'm Jason Napolitano. I'm the founder of Scarlet Moon Productions, which is a game music label. We have an album series that we produce called Prescription for Sleep Game Music Lullabies, which takes game music, and the Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater composer has arranged and performed that live to sleep and relax to, so they're jazzy lullabies. And we have six albums in that series. We also do promotions for composers and music labels. And then lastly, we represent talent to work on video games and other media, including our good friend here, Mr. Hiroki Kikuta, who most of you probably know from Secret of Mana, and I'll let you say a few words about yourself.
はじめまして、ゲーム音楽を作曲しています、Hiroki Kikuta です。
Kikuta-san has been composing music for a very long time, video game music in particular.
僕はもうゲーム音楽を作曲して27年ぐらいになるんですけども、その間ずっといろんな面白いタイトルを作ることができてとても光栄です。
So he has been doing this for 27 years. That's
27
years? He is a professional.
That's so very
And
awesome.
Some of his titles include Seiken Densetsu, which in 3, which I've grown up with.
Right.
Like they've been like really super popular. And like, you know, for the US audience, Soul Calibur.
That's,
of course. Awesome. Yes. And then one of his most secret ones has been The Secret of Mana.
Secret of Mana.
Yeah.
Ah, very good, very good. So I understand you've been here at Anime Expo. Would you like to tell us a bit about what you've got going on for Anime Expo this year? I understand it's quite involved and might be a big project or anything. So what's going on with you guys at Anime Expo?
Well, we've been billing it as Hiroki Kikuta takes over Anime Expo because it blew up from just one panel on Thursday night with Lab Zero Games, the producers of Indivisible, and it turned into that plus an indie game panel that we did earlier today, plus two autograph sessions, plus this interview where we're going to have some exclusive news for you guys. So Anime Expo has been incredibly busy for us, but it's been so great to see the fans and have people braving the sweltering heat to come to these panels. It's just been, it's been amazing.
本当にいつもあのファンの人と会うと思うんですけども、僕の作った音楽が例えばその聖剣伝説2っていう音楽だったら、それはもう25年ぐらい前の仕事、ね、本当に昔の仕事なんですけど、でも未だにみんなが本当に心から愛してくれて、で僕に会いに来てくれる、で作曲家としてはこんなに嬉しいことはないなといつも思っています。
It has been 25 years since he composed Seiken Densetsu 2, but still there are fans, so many fans out there, and he has been able to actually meet them, like here at Anime Expo yesterday at his autograph signing, and it's, you know, it's a very inspirational, like, it's very, like, heartfelt moment to get to see those fans who are still playing, who still love the music, still love the game.
Is that something that draws you to really enjoy AX, you know, the fan experience, is that one of the things that you guys like about AX and being here?
I know, Anime Expo でこうやって実際にファンの方とお会いできるのってやっぱり素晴らしいことですか？すごい言いたい気になってますよね。
もうどれだけ素晴らしいかって僕言葉にできないぐらいです。そしてファンの人と会うことで僕はエネルギーをもらうし、愛情をもらうし、でそのエネルギーが、僕が今インディビズブルを作っている音楽のために、その音楽を素晴らしいものにするために、僕がとてもその なんて言うんだろうな、その力を使って素晴らしい曲ができるというのが本当のところなんです。
you know, He's almost speechless. Like, you know, words cannot express how amazing it is to meet fans of his music here today at Anime Expo. And you know, that is definitely like an inspiration for him to keep, you know, creating his new music and what he's working on currently for Indivisible. You know, having that feedback, having that inspiration directly from fans is what keeps him going.
And for me, it's just, you know, what I do is a lot of behind the scenes stuff, you know, mm-hmm. the promotions, the management, and the releasing the music. So when I come to these events and people know Scarlet Moon and, you know, they're asking how they can work with us, that's just a whole new level of, oh my gosh, people actually know what it is we're doing. So that's kind of the goal of coming out here and just letting people know that amazing composers like Kikuta-san are available to work on their games or projects and that kind of stuff, because people would think he's untouchable, he's this legend. So it's been really rewarding in that sense.
Oh, very good, very good. How did you both get started with music? You know, it's, you had such storied careers with it, even just with behind the scenes. What spawned the love of music and the decision to go into this industry?
For me, I mean, it's a kind of a childhood upbringing, you know, the school of Nintendo and the NES, you know, sitting there playing Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest and Super Mario. And, you know, we had an old friend who was older than us who would play through all these games, and my best friend and I would watch him, and we would hum the melodies to drive him crazy. So we would actually get a turn to play the games. So, I mean, it evolved into, you know, writing about game music from a journalistics perspective to now doing what I'm doing, where I get to be the first one to hear the new soundtrack that he's cooking up. So as the fan in me, it's like the ultimate reward to be doing this work, because I get to hear the music first. So it's been since early childhood for me.
Kikuta-san, game music is of course, but the music itself to start the beginning of the world, or to enter this world, is there anything to do with this world? Yeah, the music
to eat dinner I didn't think of as a child. I don't think of it anymore, but でも本当にいろんな偶然が重なって僕は、この世界に入ることができて、スーパーファミコンというハードの本当に黄金時代を経験することができたっていうのはとっても幸運だったなと僕は思っています。
Now, Kikuta-san has just told me that when he was younger, he never had thought that it would be possible to, you know, keep make a living doing music, creating music. No, even now he's like still wary about it because it'san art form and it's not stable, but you know what keeps him going is it's the love for it, and he's so humble about the fact that he was able to live through that golden age of like Super Famicom, Super Nintendo, you know, and he says that he's very fortunate and thankful for all the fans and the love that he gets.
Well, definitely, you know, I don't know if I can speak on behalf of the fans, but you know, just hearing that, thank you, Kikuta-san, for the work. So I'm being told that before we go, we're told you guys have some exclusive news to share with us regarding what Kikuta-san and Scarlet Moon are working on next. Is that correct?
That's absolutely true. Just for everyone watching here right now, we got two upcoming games that we're going to be working on after Indivisible. The first is a game that was announced called Hazelnut Bastille, and it's a 16-bit top-down kind of Zelda RPG-style game, and they're aiming to have 2 to 6 songs from Kikuta-san, and they're going to be using an authentic 16-bit sound set, so just like the Super Nintendo, and it's going to be using Greek instrumentation. He's going to be doing the main dungeon theme, so you're going to be hearing his music a lot. And the second reveal we have for you, we're really excited to announce that we're going to be working on it with a studio called Meowza Studios. It's being published by Humble Bundle. It's a name called Mineko's Night Market. And this is a fun game where you collect items and you build crafts, all cat-style things to sell at the night market in the game. Really gorgeous artwork, and we're really looking forward to contributing to that later this year.
Good, good. Excellent.
I have a quick question. I heard that Kikuta-san gets, you know, inspirations. You know, I just heard that there's a little Greek influence in there. Are there other influences to your music? Oh, I just talked about it in English, didn't I?
それはなぜか僕はできるんですね。 多分いろんな国のいろんな音楽を自分の血の中に取り込んで、それを自分のものとして出せるっていうのが多分一番僕の面白い才能なんじゃないかなと思ってます。
Kikuta-san just told me that, you know, that's one of his talents, being able to、have an input from different sorts of music, like different、music from different countries. They're very specific, and he's able to put that all into himself、and then、mash it up and mix it up and create his own. That is、one of the strong points that he has.
Excellent. Well, again, thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining us. I understand、we're going to take a quick、short break here. So, again, thank you so much for joining us.、it's been an honor and a pleasure, and、we hope to see more of the magic and the artistry that、mm-hmm.you're both bringing to us. Yes. So.
And tomorrow we still have an autograph, like a signing for Kikuta-san.
Oh, very good.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
今日はありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。